Y'all, I'm on like cloud nine over here. I don't know if it's written all over my face or what. But my phone fell. Sorry. I am in charge of this project at work, and I am having like so much fun. I am getting paid to not only film and direct and get all creative with this project of ours, but I'm also editing and getting praise and kudos and atta girls, and I'm really like, I'm on cloud nine. I'm feeling very fulfilled. I'm feeling very passionate about my project I'm doing. We are creating a slideshow, right? What do you do, right? Everyone's creating a slideshow, just about. And the slideshow is going to have facts and statistics and photos and audio. And that's just a facade, okay? After that, we are having one of the main co-workers from our group. He's the star of our little project. He's going to play it up like he's Bruno Mars, or technically Bruno Stars, and he's going to dance to a bunch of different things with all the people in the different businesses and stuff, and I don't know, it's just kind of fun. So we've got this idea, and we're just doing choppy little 10-second videos here and there, and it's up to me to put it together. It's up to me and my expertise and my creativity to come all together and be very ta-da. So I am both excited and nervous. I'm excited because I'm pretty confident in my skills, that I'm not like showing off to a bunch of video editing professionals. I know that these people probably can't do even half of what I can do with computer and video and editing and music and all that stuff. I'm sure that's not a hobby that a lot of people in the finance department has. That's one of my hobbies. I enjoy doing stuff like this. And even though I don't do it for these videos, for my journals, because that would just take too much time, and that's kind of stupid to put so much time in all these videos, I got two other YouTube channels. I've got my personal one for, I shouldn't say personal, I got my family one, the one that I share with my family, my kids, my husband, you know, brother when he came up and we did a video. That's my family, my public one, I should say, the one that I share with people. This is my personal one, the one I don't share with people, but I do have it public in case there are people out there watching that might be interested in what I'm saying, and if they are, that'd be cool to hear from them, and I can feel like I understand what you're watching my videos for, if it's for more positive stuff, if it's for more realness. I'd like to know that. I'd like to know am I speaking enough about my problems to help you? Would that help you to speak more about my problems, or would it help you more to speak about the positive stuff and the things I'm learning and the analogies that I find really helpful, or what my therapists are trying to teach me and the books I'm reading? I don't know. I'm just blabbering and I'm going on and on. And then my third YouTube channel is the D Slob Student. Yes, I think I've mentioned it before. I'm not really sure anymore. But the D Slob Student, I started as my own video journey to have a cleaner house, because the video journeys have been, I'm sorry, the cleaning journeys on my personal one if I ever wanted to share my cleaning struggles with a family member or a friend who I don't want to know my marriage struggles, I didn't want them to bleed too much, so I had to separate them. And so the separating of them helps me stay anonymous. You don't really know who I am. I don't say my name in the DSLAB student or talk about stuff very much like that. It's just more, yeah. Anyways, whoa, I'm just getting really amped up. I think I'm getting amped up because I'm so excited about the video. Oh, that's what I was gonna say. My husband had to go to work early, so I got up early and worked on my music video. So he's Bruno Mars and he's doing Uptown Funk, and I have all these different videos from all these different scenes, and I didn't have enough footage for just one scene throughout the whole song, which is fine. I wanted it to be split up, and then I had too much and I had to cut out my least favorite, and it all works out because he doesn't lip sing, which is great, because if he lip sing, that'd make my job even harder. But there's a couple times where he says, "Don't believe me, just watch." He's not saying it. He's just doing motions like, "Don't believe me, just watch." And then he also does, "I'm too hot." And he goes like this. So the music video matches up perfectly. Like, and guys, part of being codependent is I don't allow myself to get attracted to an opposite sex. So even if I wanted to get attracted to this Bruno Mars lookalike imitator, whatever he is, coworker, I couldn't even allow myself to. That's not what this is about. So I don't want you to think that I'm getting excited because I'm attracted to him. I'm excited because I get to edit videos. I get to edit videos and show off my work and show off my hobby and show off my skills, and I'm really proud of that. And so I'm just using his videos as this way of showing them. Does that make sense? I'm excited. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. Oh. I worked on the music video for 2 hours this morning, and that's 2 unpaid hours. That's how passionate I am about this project. Is I don't even care if I get paid for it or not. The reason why I had to do it this morning is because my husband coincidentally had to go to work early, and so I used that time to get a lot of that music video done. I'm afraid that if I try to work on the music video while he's home, then his bad vibes will mix with my good vibes and it will bring me down. I will have a hard time keeping my mood up. I will have to face those triggers. I will have to deal with those triggers, and I don't want to deal with triggers. So I'd rather just work on the music video when he's not there. And I can work on boring slideshow stuff when he's gone. Yeah. We got it figured out. Anyways, that makes me sad. And I didn't want to say that. I didn't want to talk about it because that brings me down when I talk about things that make me sad. But I do have to recognize that sometimes talking about things that make me sad help me stay balanced, because if I stay real and true to what is, and what is that I don't feel like I can be myself around my husband. I feel that his insecurities trigger me so badly because I'm so codependent and enmeshed that I want his approval so much that if I can't get his approval, then I kind of fall apart. And I didn't get his approval when I shared with him about the project, and I barely got to say anything. He went straight to whatever assumptions he had, and that just broke my heart that that I can't even share with him the facts, not his assumptions, but the facts that I get to be in charge of a project. I was really, really proud of that. And I was so proud that I got to be in charge of a project, and so proud that I got to use my skills and have fun at work, that I want somebody in my life that can just be proud with me and not let their insecurities overshadow my pride, my proud moment. Yeah. And I can't, I don't have that. So that makes me sad. And I can't stop him from having his feelings, nor do I want the responsibility to fix his feelings. But if his feelings affect me so badly, then I need to take responsibility and either face the music when I need to face the music, or avoid facing the music if I know it's healthier for me not to face the music. That's how I think. I think it's healthier to not force myself to face musics that I don't have to face if it means I don't have to fall apart. I don't want to fall apart, and I want practice on not falling apart. So this is just not one of them. I would feel too passionately about this and I would fall apart if... I'm not strong. I don't know how to be strong. I'm not strong enough to do that. I want to be strong. I am strong somewhere inside of here, but it comes with a price. I can either be strong and respectful and loving to my husband and control what I tell him so that I don't fall apart if he doesn't know, then I can't fall apart. That's me being strong because I love my husband that much, and I don't want to upset him because his being upset is making me upset. Or I could be strong without him, and that's definitely the black and white thinking. I don't know how to do the gray. That's my frustration. That's where I'm at right now. All right, I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.